Sit down.
The blanket that normally goes between.
Sit down.
She's only three.
Yeah.
All right. Tipsy, goodbye.
That's what we all do too.
There you go.
Oh, goodness.
I speak girl. Girl. Bye. Here.
So you get ten dollars.
That doesn't make you happy, but. You're not gonna be able to get it.
How would you rate mock it?
No, terrible. We don't do it till we don't.
Nice to chase them off.
Oh, no.
See, this guy.
Yeah, talks to it, and Brian on Thursday was here, he was holding it like this, and he was off the ground and he wouldn't let go.
But he wasn't doing that before. Was he?
Oh, we were mocking him.
They're coming along.
Yeah. He's like, no, they're all true. You can believe them, they're all true.
Yeah, it's empty, so now they just chew it.
So when he got to the shelter, they said he was 1.5. Then the clinic examiner said, no, he's 1.5.
He's still got some puppy in it, but.
And he can break down a bone too.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've got him listening to shepherd mix, and he's got a lot of.
You did, chill.
And he's got that higher intensity level, so the shepherd's in. And he's like, he's jumping.
I know.
He's a lot of dog.
Yeah. Is this gonna be? No, I'm not sure what she is, but she's not an English bulldog. She's got some pit bull in her. And, I'm not really sure what she is.
She's like a 4-year-old.
She's a very, very sweet girl. So, you know, that she's 51 pounds, 3 years old. She was saved by an animal protection officer. She's been in the shelter since March 12th. And then this just continues on with, like, the medications that they gave her upon arrival. And it says, out in the play yard, she had a loose body with a low tail and appropriately tolerated the other dogs through the fence. In the yard, she was nervous at first, but tolerant of the other dogs and kept to herself. She corrected appropriately as well as respected corrections from other dogs. She was steerable by handler while in the yard. Harley was stoic and easygoing. She's shy, nervous, friendly, able to leash, and unleash. She walks really nice on a leash. I've walked her. She's just a little nervous around people. I mean, but I don't. Where are they? All right.
A little bit of chicken skin, hot dogs, kibble.
I can imagine.
Sure.
Yeah, I took Otto out not that long ago. Pretty long walk. But you have to drive fast. Oh,
Yeah, that's definitely not her. No, she's all pretty.
Hey, you're okay, buddy. You're okay.
And they don't get a lot of those at PACC. And when they do show up, they tend to get adopted almost immediately. Yeah, it's hard. They do something hard to consider. Instantly what's the word I'm looking for? I know that that's such a pity thing too. You don't see very many other breeds do that, but pitties always lay like this. Yeah.
And you know, when we're walking, people will want to come up. I say, no, don't. She's beautiful, but I said, you know, she kind of gets scared around strangers, so you know,
right?
Just don't. But it's worrisome, and I tell people, unless you yourself have training, because even though they're the calmest thing in the world and they love you and they're the sweetest vibe, you have to understand how to breed.
Right, exactly. And well, strong. And I think that's the case with a lot of the larger, bigger breeds, because that's what happens. People, German Shepherds, Malinois, they fall in love with a certain type of dog because of how they look. Well, you need to know what you're going to be dealing with. How they look is all fine and great. It's if you don't know the breed, like, for somebody to take on Bixby, he's not a just everybody kind of dog.
No.
Hi, you guys are welcome up here in the front. We just got a couple that are not okay with outside dogs.
Okay.
Thank you. You're gonna behave yourself right now. Nope. You're fine. You're fine. Hey, you're fine. Stop. See, do you see what you do? You chase people away. That's not nice. You're okay. It's all right. You're fine. That's my front yard. Get out of here.
But, you know, I tell everybody, any dog can get and have a tendency to be that way.
Yeah, until you know.
But these type of things, yeah, we'll just go at it.
When they're not that cute little puppy anymore, they throw them in the backyard, they don't get any more pain, very little interaction.
Smart dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, you can't.
They'll get into trouble.
That's exactly. exactly right. Well, that's when he's a sleep artist. That's how he ended up in the shelter. He's been adopted through the shelter now twice. So.
He jumps over the wall.
Well, he's done it here. He's done it. That's why he came. This is his favorite spot right here. He goes right over. It gives him just the right amount of leverage that he needs to get up and over. And he hasn't quite figured out that he can just use his head and head out. He literally will stand there and try and stick his nose in the wedge to try to open it, and that doesn't work for him. So, yeah. I've said that for years being at PACC, that I would much rather deal with the bigger dogs. They give good warnings before they bite. Little dogs sometimes just go right at you.
Yeah,
no warning.
I picked up my friend Lily was sick, and I was taking care of her. And so people were there, and the dog just kept get in everything. So I knew this dog. I picked it up. It was fine. It turned around and bit me right in the nose. And they're just nasty sometimes. I don't
Some of them really are. Yeah, I'm a big dog person personally. I've just always had big dogs. But, you know, the older I get, the really big, strong ones,
mm-hmm.
I'm starting to understand my limitations. That I can't do what I could do 10 years ago. I just can't. I don't have the strength. I don't have the stamina. You know, 10 years ago, I would have brought Ginger home in a heartbeat. Wouldn't have thought twice about it. He'd been part of my pack, and that would have been that. I can't do that. I know that I can't do that. I got two strong dogs right now. I can't.
It's exhausting. I mean, even when we want to have work done at your house and you have the dog, you just don't know how they're going to react to people.
Yeah.
You've got to go between them.
Well, and mine, because it's just me and the dog, so they're very, very protective.
And you don't. It's exhausting. I tell people, you know, you need to get because I never had it, but then I had a Sherman Shepherd once. Joe, I had two. I had Maggie and Joe. My Maggie was the best dog.
I know when I first didn't really go.
She would stay away.
Right. Yeah, back off, please. Yep. That's my female that I saw now. That's how she is. She's fine. Like, this distance is acceptable for her. But if you come any closer and she's going to pick up on your energy, if she doesn't like your energy, you're not going to get any closer than that. That's as close as she's going to allow you to come.
Right in between you. And then the light came on. Oh boy, so I took a step back because she got right in between.
I'll do this
next thing they do, they'll jump.
Okay. Yes.
Right.
We'll have to watch. Say just you're going to know your dog.
I've always trusted, whenever one of my dogs has them, like somebody, I've always trusted their intuition because they're picking up on something that I'm not.
Just stay there with her.
When they did the same thing.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, it's good to see you again.
Bye,
thanks for coming in.
Hi, sweet boy. What's the
matter? What are you doing?
You threw me in a pill.
Yeah.
Good for the rest of
the I tell her you gotta go to the bed. I'm gonna get her a shirt made that says Junkyard Princess.
So this is what I was talking about. Blue Mountain.
Okay.
She's really Dr. Mary said, yeah, she's really amazing. So can't say enough good things about her. The last she gave us an extra two quality paints before. We knew what the outcome would be, but and she doesn't. What I really appreciate about her is that she doesn't. She didn't know, like so many vets, they want to do the most expensive things, and you know all the blood work. She's like, she will ask you where you are with it, like you know what you need most comfort with, and she's not going to be terribly aggressive with things unless that's what you want to do. So
that's
okay. Don, just don't even try and take it from him. Yeah. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
I gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Thank you. Bye, Rambo. See you later. Bye, sweetheart. See ya. Where are you going?
It should be.